How's it going, everybody? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my latest Let's Play of Train Simulator Classic. And today, folks, we're going to be covering the Huddersfield line. And this time around, in the third video, we're using the Class 158. That's the free car version, and this is the Class 158-8. And we're going to be doing a passenger service from Manchester, Victoria, going to Leeds this time around. So, unlike the past two videos, where we was going towards Manchester, this one, and this is the first scenario that comes with a park, well, the route add-on, we will be going towards Leeds this time around. So, without further ado, let's unpause the game, and let's load up the passengers, and let's get this train ready for service then. Okay, what I'm going to do, I will do the thumbnail once we are on the move, as it is a bit undercover here in Manchester, Victoria. So once we get out on the open rails, I will do the thumbnail. And without further ado, let's get our train ready to go. I'll just do the buzzer to the guard to acknowledge the signal, and without further ado, let's get started. Also, now we're furthest away from those Class 142 paces, which are quite noisy, if I must say so myself. At least we will be able to hear what this train should actually sound like, as this one is much quieter. But I believe this is the Armstrong Parhurst Class 158 sounds. I'm not sure if they are Cummins or Perkins engine sounds, but as I have both parks, which I have covered in the past, and this one is a Class 158-8 free car, as this is one of the Trans Pennine versions that allows higher capacity compared to the two car versions. So I think it's a Perkins, but anyways, continuing onwards. Okay, folks, we are coming up to the junction, so I'm just idling the bar here just to allow us to slow down for the upcoming 30 miles an hour speed limit, as that will be enforced as we go round the corner onto the junction, which will take us onto the Huddersfield line, and we're just going to use a wee bit more power just to keep our speed going, as we don't want to lose too much, as we are going uphill, but we don't want to go too fast where we are going to be breaking the speed limit either. So it's just a matter of just getting the balance right. And in truth, I don't really use these trains very often, as I much prefer locomotive haul trains. That's just my personal preference. Anyways, we're now in the 30 miles an hour zone. So once we get past this, I will open up the park so we can build up our speed again. We are now clear of the speed restriction, so let's get the power back on and go full power to bring us up to line speed, and that will increase to 75 miles an hour, and that should go up to 85 eventually. And what I will do, folks, once we are clear of all these trees and stuff, once we get a bit of open land, in fact I'm going to take that opportunity now and do the thumbnail. Well, that's the thumbnail done, so I can just stay in the cab now until we get to Leeds, as that is the limit of this route. As then, as you know, I do like to stay in the cab as much as I can, as it's more realistic. Don't get me wrong, I do love to do the line side thumbnails and stuff, but mostly, for most of the journey, obviously, I do prefer to stay in the cab just to keep it more realistic and stuff, but it's great to have external views, as I think this one, along with Trains in World 3, actually they offer you external cameras, same with Trains and Train Life, but the older BBE train simulator, that was just cab view only. Not sure if I will cover that old train simulator in any future Let's Plays, but I will check that out and see if that's evolved since I last played it in the 2000s. But it is a Japanese train simulator, and there was some cool routes and stuff available for that back in the day. As you know, I do like to try different things, and I'm keeping my fingers crossed for a good deal on Train Sim World 3, as I'm planning to do that in December, folks, as I want to cover the current... As I was saying there, I want to cover the current class, and I do want to cover some of the other add-ons that are not available for Train Sim World 2. I would like to try out those BNSF American locomotives and stuff, you know. Okay, we're just about just under 3 miles to go before we reach Stalybridge. That will be our next station stop. Okay folks, we're not too far away from Stalybridge, so I better start slowing down. I'm just using step one braking here, just to keep the journey nice and smooth for the passengers. Just coming into Stalybridge, folks. That was quite a nice smooth run, but either way I'm gonna keep going no matter what. I don't know what's the matter with my voice today, as it just keeps breaking up, but I'm gonna keep narrating and I'm gonna keep going. As you know, I never give up and I never give in. Okay folks, our next stop will be Huddersfield. That's in about 17.93 miles to go from here. So this is more or less a semi-direct run with the major stations served on the way. And I do have some custom scenarios planned for this route that I will be making of my own as well. So I will cover those in future Let's Plays. So, that I'm looking forward to. gotta be honest with you folks, this train does sound a lot better with the Armstrong RR sounds compared to the old default ones. And it will be interesting to see if any repaints use this model to allow compatibility with the Steam Workshop. So anyways, I'm enjoying this one. And we are just about under 16 miles to go to Huddersfield. Okay, just wanted to make sure that we got the horn done at the whistle board, and I had to ease up the car there just so that we didn't go too fast around that corner and stuff. We are in the 65 mile an hour speed zone. I think it goes up to 75 after Huddersfield, I don't know, but we've got quite a way to go before we reach our next station either way. We're just coming up to a 15 miles an hour speed zone, folks, so I'm just slowing down nice and early just so that we do not break the speed limit. So I'm using step one just to bring us down, and then I will open up the car again once we are clear of the speed restriction. Okay, I'm not sure what that was all about, but the 15 miles an hour speed that came upon the HUD, it didn't actually kick in, it still said 60, so I kind of slowed down for nothing there. So, not sure what's going on there, folks, but anyway, no bother, we'll just carry on to Huddersfield. We are still in quite a long tunnel, folks, so we'll start using a wee bit of braking just to bring us down for the upcoming reduced speed limit of 45 miles an hour. And it's nice to do something different, as we are doing the route in reverse compared to the last two Let's Plays, and I'm enjoying this one. Thank you. quite a tight corner there, folks, hence why the lower speed limit. But once we're back on the straight tracks without these twisty curves, we can then go full power. We are entering the 60 miles an hour zone, so we can just open it up a wee bit more. I'll just go to notch 4, because that's about 50% power. Well, we're just coming back onto the 85 miles an hour speed zone, so we can just open up the park. But as I was trying to say earlier in this let's play, I'm looking forward to doing Train Sim World 2, well, correction, Train Sim World 3 in December, as those let's plays will cover the home pass and the two or three BNSF locomotives that come with that route. Anyway, folks, sticking on topic. Just for now, we can open this back up to full power and head for 85 miles an hour. As for Train Sim World 3, I do hope that they will make something like the North Lincolnshire line and something like this line in Train Sim World 3. Perhaps do Class 60 with the oil tankers and the Class 185 or something. That would be ideal, especially from Doncaster to Cleaford and that destinations and stuff. Gotta be honest with you folks, this is one of my favourite recent releases from Dovetail Games for Train Simulator Classic, as I really do like the Huddersfield line. It's got some nice scenery, and I do like the landscape and stuff, and it's not too laggy either, unlike some of the other routes that I've bought in the past. This one, for the last two Let's Plays, has run great. I'm looking forward to making my own scenarios and stuff. Anyways, I'm putting a wee bit of braking on. Preferably try and catch the brake button and not the cab light one, because that's right next to it. So I'm trying to ease off the power there. If I put some brake on there, just to bring us back down to the correct side of 85 miles an hour. And we will have to start slowing it down very soon, folks, because we are just under 3 miles to go to our next station stop at Huddersfield. Another thing as well, this just has a 3-step brake, as I tend to use step 2 when I'm going fast to slow down, and I'll just ease that off to step 1 and then release. I only ever use step 3 if I need to brake very hard, and I have to be careful not to put it into emergency, as I don't want to. Well, I want to give the passengers a smoother ride as I can. Anyway, folks, we're just coming up to, I think it's an upcoming 40 miles an hour speed limit, I don't know. But I know it gets quite low as we get closer to Huddersfield, and we're not too far away from there now, folks, so just better be ready to cancel that AWS before it throws the brakes on. And we are in a 60 miles an hour zone, but I'll just level off at 45. And then I'll start slowing down to 20 or whatever it is as we get closer to Huddersfield. Okay, we've been routed into platform 8. This is the very first time I've actually been routed onto this platform in any of my Let's Plays, but nice to do something different, and it keeps the content fresh, so I am thankful for that. So let's get the brakes on to level 2, just to bring us nice and down so we can stop in line and make sure all the carriages are in the platform. And I'm just going to briefly check the HUD display just to make sure that's the case. Put this in neutral and of course release the doors. Okay, without further ado, we are due to call at our next intermediate station stop of Dewsbury, and that will be platform 1. That's just about 7 miles or so away. So without further ado, let's head on towards our next station stop. Better ease off the park and just coast until we get back onto the main, as then once we are back on the main, we can then open up the park, as we are in a 40 miles an hour zone and we're just about to clear the 20 restriction out of Huddersfield. So without further ado, let's get the power back on and build our speed up nice and slowly so that we don't accelerate too fast and of course break the speed limit. So hopefully, fingers crossed, I shouldn't have to ease off, but I think we'll be grand. So let's go full power. Okay, we're not too far away from Dewsbury. And I do apologise for going a bit too fast, as, to be honest, I didn't hear that AWS. In fact, I know I was kind of talking there, but no matter. Once this train has done its business, I will continue on to Dewsbury. But as I was saying, I do apologise for going a bit too fast. I think the sounds need to be a bit louder on this train, to be honest, as the Class 47 and the Class 142 are much louder than this one, and I didn't really hear the AWS, for the sheer fact of the matter is that it's too quiet. It needs to be much louder. Anyway, it's no bother. I'll put the power back on and we'll be on our way. Just going at caution, folks, as we had a single yellow signal back there, and I don't know if the next one will be a danger or not until I get a visual, but we are just coming into Dewsbury and I think our signal is a danger. I don't know, but I'm just being careful here as I don't want to fail the mission. That said, we are coming into Dewsbury. Okay, we've made it safe and sound into Dewsbury. Just put the reverser into neutral, release the doors. Thankfully, we do have a green signal. So, I was just playing it safe there, as for all I know, this one could have been a danger signal. And I'd be correct in believing that after passing the next one on a single caution. But nonetheless, I'm not sure what the next stop will be. Hopefully, might be a direct run to Leeds, but if not, no bother. I think we might have to call at, well, I was going to say Mirfield, but nope. We've got a full run, non-stop to Leeds, and that will be our final station for this Let's Play. But nonetheless, I do hope you are enjoying it, folks. So I'm just doing my driver to guard buzzer. Place the reverser in forwards and we'll move off as before. And we've got a 75 miles an hour speed limit coming up. So once we're clear of the 40 zone, I will then open it up full power once the back of the train is clear of the 75 miles an hour speed board. okay. We're just coming up to a 55 and a 45 miles an hour restricted speed zone. So just getting ready to start slowing down nice and smoothly, as I don't want to break the speed limit. And this is another long tunnel on this route, but I do enjoy it though, as it does give me a challenge, and I do love a challenge, so it's no big deal at all. And we've got about just under 5 miles to go before we reach Leeds. Oh, and just to correct myself, that was actually 65 miles an hour, not 45 like I thought it said. Sometimes the fonts are so small, it's kind of hard to make them out. But nonetheless, I'd rather play it safe and try and stay within the speed limits, as I did exceed them a bit earlier on this let's play. But anyways, this is the third one near enough done, even though technically this is the first. Well, the first scenario, the cons of the route. And I did want to do the Class 47 first, because that is my favourite diesel locomotive. And this one, on the other hand, I don't dislike it or like it. I'm just kind of neutral with the fast 158s. But it is quite fast and fun to drive, even though I am neutral with the diesel multiple units. But anyways, not too far away from Leeds now, folks. Well, folks, what I will have to say to you is that was quite a nice, almost semi-direct run. I quite enjoyed this one. And we're near enough at Leeds, so I'm just going to idle the par, which I've done. I'm just going to use step one braking just to bring us down to the upcoming 25 miles an hour speed zone. And this will drop to 15 miles an hour as we get closer into Leeds station. But I do hope you have enjoyed this one. As always, please do feel free to leave your comments in the comment section below. And I do apologize if my narration is not the best today, as I have a wee bit of a sore throat. But nonetheless, I'm going to keep going no matter what, and I still enjoy doing these let's plays and that. And I have many more planned for this month of November. And I intend to cover Train Sim World 3 in December. as I want to end 2022 on a positive note, okay? However, that said, I do intend to do more model train reviews and stuff, and I've got a lot of plans, well, a lot of great videos planned for the next, well, for this month of November, and of course December as well. So plenty of content to look out for, folks. And as always, I do welcome your suggestions, your feedback. And also, when we come to mid-December, although I may relax the Let's Plays after this year of 2022, as I may drop it down to about 3 a week, I will do Let's Plays and stuff for 2023 of RMSI2 and Forza and all the other driving related video games, but this year is the year of the train, so when it comes to the Lunar New Year of the Rabbit, that'll be 2023, that's when the new timetable will come into effect. Anyway, folks, I just want to say to yous, big thank you for watching, take care of yourselves and each other, all the best, God bless, and I will catch you in the next Let's Play coming soon, as we will be finishing here, as we're more or less coming into Leeds. So I'm just keeping my eyes open on the signals and stuff, just so that I don't run any reds. But I've really enjoyed this one. But anyway, folks, all the best, and I will see yous in the next one. Okay, that's all for now. I will see yous in the next one.